I'm at the PortableApps.com website, going under Get Apps, and then scrolling down under Utilities, we see three PortableApps utilities. Let's look at this first one, PortableApps.com App Compactor. A quick look at that shows us that it is intended primarily for developers, but also advanced users will find this useful. Well, we're not a developer or an advanced user, so I'm going to skip this one. Let's look at the next two. And the next two take us to the same screen, which wants us to download the PortableApps.com platform. Let's download it now free. And it takes us to the SourceForge button. I'm going to click that. And now I want to save this. Alrighty, it's done. And here we have it on our desktop. I'm going to double click to open it, just like we did in our previous portable app. There's our PortableApp.com installer again. And this time I'm going to install this to a flash drive. It's installed, and I'm going to leave this check that says Launch PortableApps.com Platform. We saw that PortableApps.com Platform flash on the screen. Now we see something that says Portable Apps Directory checking for apps. This says Portable Apps Directory, and it looks like it's got all the apps categorized just like it does on the web page. I'm clicking Next. And I've got to go down to my taskbar, and I need to click on the little circle with an arrow icon to bring up the PortableApps.com platform. Looking at these first things here, we've got Documents, Music, Picture, Videos, Explore. I'm going to click Documents. We see the PortableApps.com platform hide down in our taskbar. And we see that it brings up on our removable disk, we've got Music, Pictures, Videos. If I take it up a level, we're just right at our removable disk. There's our start exe. Here's our PortableApps.com folder and our Documents folder. We see the Music, Pictures, and Videos folders that were shown on our PortableApps.com platform. When I put my arrow on the top of the PortableApps.com platform, I can move it around. To minimize the platform, I just need to click off the platform, and it hides down in the taskbar. Up in this upper right-hand corner, there's a little box. It doesn't really tell us what that's for, but if I click on it, it brings up an open dialog box. I see I've got my Frugal Computer Guy PNG in there, so I'm going to select that. And it puts my picture in the upper right-hand corner. What we really want this for is the apps. So let's click on the apps icon. We see we've got check for apps, get more apps, install a new app, and refresh apps icons. Let's click on get more apps. Since we don't have any apps at all, we can list them by category, by title, by new release, or recently updated. I'm going to select by title. And here we see all our apps again listed alphabetically by title. I'm down at the bottom. I see World Clock Portable. I want to install this, so I'm going to check it and click Next. And it's done. And here we see our World Clock Portable. To run it, I just need to single click on it. When I'm done using it, I'll click the X. Going back into the apps icon, we've got check for updates. It goes out to the internet to check to see if any of the apps that we have installed on our PortableApps.com platform have any updates. And if it does, it asks us if we want to update them now. All mine are up to date because I just downloaded it. Now let's go back into the apps icon. And it says install a new app. Now, isn't that what we just did when we did the get more apps? Well, not exactly. If I click on install new app, it's asking us if we want to install one that we've already downloaded. In the earlier video, we downloaded this Cook Timer Portable. I'm going to install that now into our PortableApps.com platform. So I've got it selected, click open. Click Run. So now we know what the PortableApps.com installer does. It installs the Portable Apps software into the PortableApps.com platform. So now we see the Cook Timer Portable as well as the World Clock Portable. If we decide we want to remove one of the apps from the PortableApps.com platform, we need to go into Explore. That takes us to the removable disk E. And we don't have to click on Explore. However we want to get to removable disk, that's where we'd go. Then we'll go into the Portable Apps. And let's say we want to remove the Cook Timer Portable. I'm going to select that. And click Delete. It's asking us to confirm the delete. I'll say yes. And it's gone. We still see it in our list of portable apps, but if I come down here to Apps and click Refresh Apps Icons, we see it disappears. Other things to note are at the bottom. It's telling us that we're looking at PortableApps.com E Drive. We've got 1.8 gigabytes free of 1.9 gigabytes. We have two buttons here on the lower right-hand corner. The X means exit out of the Portable Apps platform. This other one means close down the Portable Apps platform and eject or safely remove the flash drive. Here I've got the Portable Apps platform on a different flash drive. I've got quite a few apps listed in this one. You will also notice that the color is blue instead of red. To change the color, you just come down to Options. And we can use large fonts. We can list our apps differently. So then in these themes, you can change the colors down in this drop down. And then at the top, there are more options that you can choose from. And then in the advanced tab, there's more options as well. Now I've got quite a few apps listed here. And if we click down at the bottom, we have all portable apps. Shows me little categories. If I click on the category, it groups my apps, makes it easier for me to see them on a screen than when I have them all out here and it runs over one screen. The Portable Apps platform is great. It groups our apps and keeps them all organized on that flash drive. But is it really necessary? And the advantage of the Portable Apps platform is right here in the apps check for updates. Because a lot of these apps get updated regularly. It's easy for your apps to get out of date. I'm going to check for my updates right now. This flash drive has been sitting in my drawer for quite some time. So I won't be surprised to see a few that might need updates. And we see here that almost everything on this flash drive needs updating. It's going to take some time to update all of these. I might not want to update them all right now, so I can just uncheck the ones that I don't want to update. Or if I don't want to update any of these, I can just cancel out and skip the update for now. But I'll probably want to come back and update this later. And since I've got so many, I would probably have them all selected, click Next right before I go to bed, and let all these updates take place while I'm sleeping.